General Karamat, we are not trying to tell you that you have involvement. Ang sinasabi lang namin kanina...
Wait.
I'm still talking, you know?
Yes, sir.
Ang sinasabi lang, tinatanong ko lang, kung may kanina, tinatanong ko kung may kilala ka. Ang sabi ko, kaya nga pinakikita ko sa iyong picture, ngayon nare-recall mo na siya.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, of course, that is your excuse or your defense. But what? Ako, Colonel, at siguro mga kasapi dito, members dito, and even the public now, monitoring us, my cloud of doubt. Kasi...
Hindi lang basta-bastang Chinese ang nagtago sa sinasabing bahay ni Harry Roque. Itong si Sanliming ay bigating pugante na nasa red notice ng Interpol. Ayon sa POCC, IT manager si Liming ng Lucky South 99, ang pogo na tinulungan ni Roque aregluhin ang mga utang sa pagkor. It appears this fugitive and Roque run in the same circles. Nakakabahala ang dami ng mga dayuhang kriminal na sa bansa dahil sa pogo. While a ban was already announced, we in the Senate need to craft measures to ensure that this industry never comes back again.
Ng GPNP na mayroong nagawang maganda, si Colonel Boyacao. So why not assign Colonel Ana to other position? Why specifically yung kay Boyacao, while Boyacao have accomplished something?
If I may, Mr. Chair, during the accomplished the operation in Bamban, the chief PNP was former chief PNP Acorda. That was in the month of March. Umupo po the chief PNP April 1, si current now.
Sino nag-order na palitan si Boyacao ni Ana?
Si General Marvel, Mr. Chair.
Yes, that, yun ang inatanong natin.
Yes,
Mr. Because I think it will cause some demoralization on those officers who have successfully, no, conducted operations like this one. And then suddenly, papagtan nyo siya. Don't you think it's like improper for the PNP to do such changing of guards?
My apologies, Mr. Chair, but again, of course, the designation is, of course, within the powers of Chief PNP under Section 26.
General Rakay, I got it. So, yung executive, within the address of Congressman Masinda, kaprasa na lang po. I just wanted to find out why all of the sudden, napaltan agad si Boyacao. And as a matter of fact, kanina sinasabi mo, that there is a certain Colonel Busida, Alejandro, also?
Yes, Mr. Chair. After operation ng CIDG3 headed by Colonel Alejandro, the following day, i-relieve din po siya eh.
So, ang nag-relieve dito, during that time ng February 2, 2023, is not CPNP Marbil. This is during the time of Acorda. And who is the CIDG chief during this time?
All this time, General Karamat.
General Karamat. Siya na naman, General Karamat, you have to stay here. Sit down, please. So, dalawang relief ang ginawa mo. Isa nung February 2 with Colonel Alejandro and the other one is with Colonel Boyacao. After all the successful operation, what I heard from Colonel Busita, Congressman Busita, parehong-pareho that nag-operate, naging successful, tapos nire-relieve. Pero, different GPNP. Am I correct, General Karamat?
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, sir. No, sir. I was not, to clarify the matter, sir, I was not the one who relieved Colonel Boyacao. But in the case of Colonel Alejandro...
Wait. General, ikaw ang chief CIDG?
Yes, sir.
So, it's command responsibility. Oh, ikaw pa rin nag-sign. But there are orders coming from the higher-ups. Is that what you're trying to say?
That's correct, Your Honor.
So, during these two instances, wherein the first nare-relieve si Colonel Alejandro and Colonel Boyacao, ikaw ang CIDG chief.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman, sir.
Yes, that's the reason why your answer is wrong when you say no. So, ibig sabihin, ikaw ang pumirma, pero may utos si taas. Ganun ba yan?
That's correct again, Your Honor.
Okay. So now, going back to the interpellation of Congressman Bosita, we are just wondering, dahil kung panahon ni Alejandro, February 2, 2023, ang CPLP dito ay si Acorda. Am I correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And during the relief of Colonel George Buyacao, it was already CPLP Marvin.
Correct, Your Honor.
That's it. Correct. So now, and during these two incidents, you are the chief CIDG. Am I correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Ayan. Oh, so ikaw yung common denominator dito sa pag-relieve ng dalawang grupong ito. Ang tanong natin niya kanina, tinatanong niya, no? Tinatanong ko rin, why is it that after the successful operation, after a day, nirelieve natin si Colonel Alejandro at ito namang si Colonel George Buyacao ay nirelieve din during your time? Why?
Thank you, Your Honor. Let me clarify my position, sir.
Go ahead.
In the case of Colonel Alejandro, the cause of his relief has no connection to the operation of Banban. Before the operation in Banban last February 2023, Colonel Alejandro was already informed of the impending reshuffle of all the regional, of some regional chief of the CIDG. So he was informed already before the raid in Banban happened, sir. So it was a normal rotation of all my regional chiefs because as a commander then, newly assigned commander or director of CIDG, I have to put in place my commanders whom I have the trust and confidence, sir.
Okay. So, General Karamat, kailan ka po na-appoint bilang chief CIDG?
January 1, 2023.
And when was the operation of the operation doon sa Banban?
February 2023. And in
February 1, 2023.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And in fact...
Wait. General Karamat.
Yes, sir.
So you were appointed as CIDG, na-assign ka, January 2023.
Yes, sir.
February 1, nagkaroon ng operation, and then February 2, na-relieve si Colonel Alejandro.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Si Alejandro, ang position niya during that time is?
Regional Chief of CIDG Region 3, sir.
Okay, Region 3. May correct to assume that during that operation, it was the Region 1 who augmented the operation?
That's a different operation, sir.
Kailan nag-augment ang Region 1 instead of Region 3? Kasi I have a report here that's telling us that the operation that was conducted, augmentation ng galing sa Region 1, hindi sa Region 3.
That was the operation led by the PAOK and Colonel Buyacao, sir.
That is during the time of General Acorda, am I correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
But hindi kinuha sa Region 3? Di Acorda?
That I cannot answer, sir. That's the wish of...
Is it a trust and confidence situation?
I think so, Your Honor.
And that's the reason why Region 1 ang pinadala augmentation imbis na Region 3. Who handles Region 3?
Again, I cannot answer that. I don't want to speculate. I don't want to question the wisdom of Dean.
Ikaw ang CIDG nun, eh. Ikaw si CIDG, you should know.
To inform this committee, the operation in Banban that was led by Colonel Buyacao, I was on leave and I was not even informed of that operation. Even my command group was not informed.
So, hindi ka na-inform ng higher-ups doon sa operation ng Banban?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And the reason why is?
I was on leave.
On leave?
Yes, sir. I was on leave abroad.
So, in other words, kaya nagkaroon ng... augmentation ng Region 1?
Again, I cannot answer that.
Kasi alam mo, nagtatalo isip po dito, eh, bakit gagamitin ng Region 1 instead of Region 3? Precisely, yun yung mga kanilang area of jurisdiction eh. And I think we need to ask the former PNP chief, General Acorda, to shed light on this. Because I will tell you, General Karamat, if you're going to relieve all these people, no, and assigning them to the different parts of this country, there is a pending case. So yung pending case ito, nandito sa korte, di ba? Asan yung mga kasong ito? Sa Bulacan? Paano sila makakabalik para to monitor the case that was filed against these, ano, against these perpetrators?
Yeah.
And assigning them, no, parang I think is not to the best interest of the organization. Unless, there is a clandestine, no, effort to really put the case on the garbage. And as a matter of fact, General Karamat, yung kaso ngayon is under RFI, di ba? Recommended for further investigation. Am I correct, General Karamat? Is this under RFI? All the cases that was initiated by Colonel Joshua Alejandro, the regional chief, siya pala ang regional chief ng CIDG. Siya pala. Si Alejandro, Joshua Alejandro, siya ang regional chief. Hindi mo kilala? General Karamat?
Of course, I know him.
Oh, that's why I'm asking you a while ago. Sino ang regional director ng ano? Ng Region 3? Sabi mo, hindi mo alam.
I didn't say that, sir.
Pero sabi mo kanina?
Your Honor.
Pero sabi mo kanina?
It was Colonel Alejandro yung unang operation against the Pugo.
Ito ang tanong ko ulit, General Karamat. Si Colonel Alejandro ang regional director ng Region 3. Siya ang nag-operate, di ba?
Yes, Your
siya
Honor.
Ang nag-operate sa Hongsheng Gaming Technology sa Bamban. But the augmentation of the people that was used is under Region 1. Correct. And you were telling us a while ago, you were on leave.
The augmentation from Region 1 was a different operation conducted by Colonel Alejandro.
We the Bamban? You other out?
We, the CIDG had conducted the operation, sir.
Yes. Okay. So yung augmentation ng Region 1 ay hindi sa Bamban?
Again, it was the operation led by Colonel Buyaka when there is an augmentation coming from Police Regional Office 1 and Cordillera, sir.
Okay. OTF, you conducted this operation. Can you kindly confirm the statement made by General Karamat?
The first operation, sir, I think yung kay Colonel Alejandro, sir, it's a different one. And the second operation, same area to, sir, yung sa Banban po, Your Honor. And the second one, yung sa Sunyu one, sir. Ito, sir, yung kay Colonel George Buyakaw. And that's true, sir. Ang ginamit pong augmentation doon are personnel or police personnel coming from Region 1 and Cordillera.
So in other words, kuyong kay Buyakaw, yun ang gumamit ng augmentation coming from the Region 1.
Yes, yes, Your Honor.
Okay, same question, General Karamat. Why is it during your incumbency as the regional chief of the CIDG, no? Bakit ang ginamit is Region 1 not Region 3? Do you know this or you're still on leave? Still, on leave ka rito.
Again, sir, I was not informed of that operation, sir. That particular operation, sir.
Hindi mo man ako papansin, pati hindi ka na-involve sa operations. Why is that so?
It's only the former chief PNP that cannot answer that question, sir.
And that's the reason why we have to invite the former chief PNP to shed light on this. Because, para ako may nakikita mga missing link dito eh. I need to be given more information for us to find out the deeper problem arising this relief of these successful operations. Hindi ko talaga makomprehend kung bakit yun ni-relieve eh. Yung mga tao pagkatapos, imbis na bigyan natin sila ng pabuya, di ba? Kasi alam nyo, ako hindi ako police, pero I know for a fact that kapag napunta ka sa NCR, parang ano yan eh, level up eh. Pero putting your people outside, no, after the complete successful operation, that will put a doubt
on the transfer.
May clarify, sir, para hindi tayo nagkakagulo dito.
Hindi, magulo talaga kasi yung sagot mo kanina, you just leave because of that. You did not know that operation because you're on leave. Diba?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Oh, that was February.
No. That's a different operation, sir.
Hindi, wait.
Ito ang operation tayo dito, sir. Yung
time ni, ano lang, ni Alejandro, no operation.
Okay, sir.
You're on leave or not?
No, sir.
Oh, so, alam mo?
Yes, sir. Because actually, sir,
yes,
I personally know the operation, sir.
Andali ko. Yes, sir. Lang muna.
Yes, sir.
Oh, do you know the operation of Colonel Alejandro?
Because right. I was the one who approved the said operation, sir.
Okay, you approve now.
Yes, sir.
How long is Colonel Alejandro as the RFU of?
Medatnan ko na lang siya po, sir, sa RFU 3 when I was assigned as the Director of Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, sir.
Kaya nga eh. That is why I'm asking you now, how long did Colonel Alejandro stayed? Kasi sagot mo kanina, rutinary, di ba? Di ba sagot mo kanina, rutinary?
Yes, sir.
Oh, kasi yung sagot mo, rutinary at saka trust and confidence.
Yes, sir.
Oh,
that's correct, sir.
At tanong ko nga, when was Colonel Alejandro assigned as Region 3 Chief? Ay, sagot mo kanina, rutinary. Then, trust and confidence.
According to my staff, sir, he was assigned there as a regional chief of CIDG in Region 3 for 6 months, sir.
Oh, 6 months. Oh, kita mo. 6 months before his relief.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Oh, kita mo 6 months? Hindi, pwede yan. Kung talagang promotional, purposes, kasi full colonel na siya eh. Diba, kailangan niya kumuha ng, kung nasa linya sa, pwede kukunin yung entry, di ba? Now, but the question is, it's just 6 months now. Okay, rutinary, medyo malabo. Next is trust and confidence. Nakaupo ka, alam mo yung operation niya, successful ang operation niya. Is it that trust and confidence with regards to your trust?
As I said,
Colonel Alejandro?
As I said before, sir, before the operation conducted by Colonel Alejandro, which was personally approved by me, he was informed already of the impending reshuffle.
And alam ko yon.
Yes, sir.
Alam ko yon. But ang sinasabi mo is, he was informed. But now, ang basis mo is rutinary. Hindi pwede, 6 months. Second is trust and confidence. He was informed, but this operation is successful. And during rutinary, suspicion operation, question of trust and confidence. You don't have trust and confidence to a police colonel that has just operated successfully against Mogo?
As I said, there is no connection to the operation of Pogo. Colonel Alejandro was relieved.
Of course, that is your excuse or your defense. But what? Ako, Colonel, at siguro mga kasapi dito, members dito, and even the public now, monitoring us, may cloud of doubt. Pasensya na po, the back of my mind is, it is not all about rutinary and the question of trust and confidence. Kasi rutinary, malabo. Trust and confidence, magandang performance, successful yung operation. So, that's what you're telling us na na-inform. Pero kahit na-inform mo magaling palang bata to eh. Diba? Kaya, Mr. Chairman, yung doubt, personally, yun din siguro yung mga nasiisip ng mga members dito, yung dapat, Mr. Chairman,